everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. The Big Ten has changed a lot in the last few years. The offenses have become more explosive. The ankles aren't quite as thick. Everything moves a little bit faster. And that is especially true in the Big Ten championship game. Thanks for checking out the pregame show. NCAA college football action coming up next with Brad and Kirk on the call. David and I will see you at halftime.
Championship game underway, and you can be sure that each of these teams are ready to lay it all on the line.
Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything.
Indiana is lined up to kick the ball off first, and we are ready to go. Lewis from the three at the 30. He's taken down at the 40-yard line.
You gotta love opening a game with a solid kick return like this.
So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Taken down right around the 48-yard line.
Well, that's a big gain there for the offense. And all that's doing is giving this quarterback more and more confidence.
From the 48-yard line, it's first down. He gets out to about the 45-yard line.
Hit out of bounds
at the 38. So he picked up a few on that run.
Yeah, he did a nice job of using his blockers on that run. Really a nice read.
First and 10. Ball on the 38.
How about the big fellas up front? This line will have to continue to play like that to build the consistency to help this offense be effective.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 20-yard line. And he sets a team record for career receptions.
And you know the fans really appreciate the effort he's given them over his time here. They're smart, and they admire the drive of guys like this.
Yardage on that run. About 7 yards there on the scamper from the halfback, and that's going to be good for the first.
That's a good call going with the draw there. It put just enough pause in the defense to allow a good game.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. They'll keep it on the ground again. Touchdown, Hawkeyes!
It takes a lot of strength to run it when you're heading into a massive pile of bodies. Good job of holding on to it and getting it across the goal line.
He makes the PAT. It was a 7-play, 60-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 29-yard line. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. Quick throw incomplete, blocked his receiver.
These guys just don't seem to be on the same page, and they're going to have to be if they expect to win this game.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 29. Empty backfield. Quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. They bring him down. They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
So the sack makes this third and very long. And they get the sack, and he can't escape again.
This guy's got to show some senior leadership out there and regroup his offensive linemen. They're getting outplayed right now.
The sack makes this a fourth and very long. Porter is the punter. And down he goes at the 43. Six points and a pretty display of passing was a result of their last drive. Kirk, do you expect the defense to take a different approach here?
When this quarterback is on, he is on. It already seems like whatever this defense is trying just isn't working. But maybe if they add just a little bit more pressure, then they might be able to force him into a mistake.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 31-yard line. Iowa is up by a touchdown. Brought down at the 29.
That's a gain of two on the play. That makes it second and eight.
Quickly to the tailback. He's tackled at the 22-yard line. He ran a good route there and was able to pick up yards underneath the coverage.
It's okay to move the ball in small portions because it relaxes the offense and can open things up for the big play.
Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. Inside the 10. They'll bring him down at the 6.
It's a good job of converting on third down with the running game.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. It holds, and he's going to come up with a sack.
Man, as an offensive lineman, this is the worst thing you want to see. Your quarterback not only getting sacked, but getting hit like that. Those linemen better pick that quarterback up and start doing a better job of taking care of him.
From the 12-yard line, second down. Iowa up 7 points. Tackle made at the 2. And for Walker, he's now the school's all-time leader in receptions.
And you know the fans really appreciate the effort he's given them over his time here. They're smart, and they admire the drive of guys like this.
This is where the defense makes a name for themselves. It's third down and goal from the one. This game's already shaping up to be a good one as we head to the second quarter. The Hawkeyes with a touchdown lead. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. He gets sacked on the play. They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. Iowa can make this a two-possession game with this field goal. It's up, and it splits the uprights. Brown has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 28. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Throws quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete.
I'm not so sure he made the best decision that time. That was a pretty tight area he was trying to throw that one into.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 28-yard line. They come out on an empty backfield. Makes the catch, and look out. And he's taken down at the 40. From their own 44-yard line. Second down.
Let's go, let's go. And we got Mike, number 53. Mike, 53.
Nice run up the middle. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 48. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Fires out to his wideout, and they push him out at about the 39-yard line. Nice run, and he's brought down. First and 10. Ball on the 32. To set up a screen for the wide receiver. And down he goes, right around the 24-yard line.
That brings up second and one.
It's the ninth play of the drive. Nice run there. Straight ahead for about 6 yards, and with that, they're going to pick up the first down.
Again, they go with the halfback here, and again, he picks up some positive yardage and a first down.
From the 18-yard line, first down. tackle at the 17. Indiana is going to take their first time out of the half. This is the 11th play of this drive. Quick shot to the tight end, and he can't pull it in. And here's another third down.
You hate to foreshadow and assume that that drop could come back to bite them, but if this offense is able to put the ball into the end zone after that drop pass, this game could be over.
And they can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here. The kick is up, and it is good. They line up to kick this one away. He'll return it from the 4-yard line. Got the corner, and he's taken down at the 34-yard line. Both offenses have played it pretty close to the vest so far in this one.
Yeah, because they've been so conservative, it's made it pretty easy for both of these defenses to be pretty dominant. Let's see an offense open it up and take a few chances.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Iowa is up a score. Throws complete. He's got space to work. And they make the stop around the 49-yard line.
You know, if you use him in this offense the right way, it's almost like you have an extra wide receiver. He's that good.
From their own 49-yard line, first down.
This quarterback is tough as nails. Brad, he's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel, almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
He's scrambling. He's at the 40. Tackle at the 35. We've got it first and 10. Ball on the 35. Quick release. Tight end. Incomplete.
Well, that was clearly a poor read on somebody's part. And the bad news is there was no defender around. If the pass was anywhere near him, it could have gone for a big play.
Going for it all to the end zone. And it's complete for the touchdown. Nicely designed play to the wide receiver, and it got him six.
You said it, Brad, and a good time to call it. I tip my hat to the offensive coordinator.
And he tacks on the extra point. A five-play, 66-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I love these kind of drives. They're old school, grind it out and earn the yards and just rip the heart right out of that defense.
Brown gets set to kick this one away. Robinson takes it at the 4, and he's tackled at the 21-yard line. The Hoosiers know, I think, that at some point they just have to do what they do, even if it's not working right now. If they can get it going in the second half, it should really improve the ball game and the offense.
Well, the offensive line, I think, also has to be accountable here. We look so much to our star players, and we always want them to put up big numbers. But to me, the two go hand in hand. When a running back's going to have a great game, the offensive line deserves some credit. When a running back's struggling, you got to look at that offensive line and say, fellas, you got to help me out. We're not going to change or deviate from this game plan. We need to be able to change this game around, and it starts up front with the offensive line.
Second and 5 coming up here. All on their own 26. gets it. He's in space. He's taken down
at about the 35.
That one goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
First and 10. Ball on their own 35. Defense coming and the ball comes out. Recovered by the offense.
Good thing they got the ball back. That fumble could have really cost them.
We're halfway through, and it's been a good one. The Hawkeyes lead it by 2 touchdowns.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Rhys Davis and David Pollack here completely locked in on that first half. So far, so good for both offenses in terms of taking care of the football, but now the defenses are ramping up the sense of urgency in terms of trying to get the ball back to their offense.
Absolutely, and you got to find Rhys. These ball hawks on defense, they need to find the football. They need to make some big plays, create some turnovers. How about using that hit stick a little bit? How about knocking somebody silly and making them drop the football? I mean, defense's number one priority is trying to turn the football over, try to make a big explosive play for your offense so they can do more damage and they can take the ball down the field. So those ball hawks need to show themselves in the second half.
David's ready to get back on that couch, get the remote, get all the games dialed up to watch what's going on around the country. Time to get you back for your second half. Brad and Kirk ready to roll.
All right, Rhys and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. Fielded at the 4. Tackle made at the 24-yard line. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. Landrum gets around 3 on the halfback draw.
We've watched this guy play, and over the course of his college career, he's made some spectacular tackles. Nice play.
From their own 27-yard line. Second down.
I really thought that the ball was going to stay in the quarterback's hands, but he made a really smart decision to pitch it out. Now they've got another set of downs to work with.
To about the 46. From their own 46-yard line, it's first down. Got his man, can't tack on any yardage. Third down, and they need to get it inside the 44. And they bring him down for a sack on the play. Fourth and long here after the sack. Porter is the punter. Yeah. tackle at the 33. So we're just about ready to return to action. Out to his receiver. Brought down at the 45. It's first and 10. Ball on the 45-yard line. The ball for a nice game.
That's a D4 on that. That makes it second and 6.
The Hoosiers running back left the game earlier with that injury. And what we're hearing now, it doesn't look like he's going to be able to return to action today. There's a strike complete. He's at the 20. He's tackled at the 16-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 16-yard line. Scrambling around. The 10. Tackle made around the 4-yard line.
That makes it first and goal.
They've got their goal line sets on the field. This might be a good time for play action. They get nice yardage on that run.
That brings up second and goal.
That brings up a second and goal. Ball on the 1-yard line. Touchdown, Hawkeyes. Splits the uprights with the extra point. It was a 6-play, 65-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points. So our score, 24-3. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Robinson from the 2. Tackle at the 20-yard line. The Hawkeyes continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
Their last drive resulted in a punt, so let's see if they can put together something a little more promising here.
If they're going to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling.
Steps up in the pocket. Second and 14. Ball on the 16-yard line. And he's taken down at the 32. And for Butler, he hauls in catch number 60.
He's become one of the real go-to guys in this offense. And when you see him out there, there's no wonder why.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 32-yard line. Play fake and looking to run. He's got the corner. Slides down. Curtis picks up about 7 yards on the scramble. Three down and one to go. Iowa's got a 3-touchdown advantage. just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. With room to work. They'll bring him down right around midfield. First and 10. Ball on the 50-yard line. Throws this one out to the right. And down he goes, right around the 20. From the 20-yard line. First down. Run play and he'll lose yards. Defensive coordinator anticipating this five-wide set, and he comes in with his dime package. Deep ball, laying it out there. Can't connect. Third and 11. Ball on the 21.
Job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Fires in there, got it, touchdown. Tight end scored that time, and with authority.
Brad is a physical football player, but he's also got the finesse to make a big impact in the passing game.
You talk about a clutch play. They couldn't afford any mistakes on fourth down there. And he hits the PAT. A nice 9-play, 80-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. Taken down at the 42-yard line. The Hawkeyes have put up 24 unanswered points. One team can't do anything wrong. The other team can't do anything right. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. He's pushed out of bounds. Right around the 28-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 28. Got it and brought down immediately.
That'll bring up second and 3.
After a decent pickup. From the 16-yard line. First down. Just under 3 to go in regulation. Tight end. What a play to set him up with a first and goal.
Man, the defense looked a little sluggish there. They can do better than that.
Iowa with a first and goal here, and this defense needs a stop or this game could get out of reach. Now he tries to buy some time. And he converts the extra point. A five-play, 42-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. The Hawkeyes defense came to play, and man, they have played beautifully.
How many do they have dressed out there? 12 or 13 defenders? I mean, they're flying all over the field, and this poor offense just can't move the ball. They have no chance.
Well, the guys are chomping at the bit down there, waiting for the game to start back up. They'll line up with five wide receivers. He steps up, looking for his man, incomplete. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 23-yard line. Just under 2 minutes in the game. It's the senior. Tackle at the 39. Good protection, and he tackles him hard at the 32-yard line. He gets rid of this one.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Third down and what they didn't want to get in. Ball on the 32. Gets it out and he's met immediately. They lose four there.
Well, that's just a sound play by the defense. They dropped him well short of the line of scrimmage.
The defense looks like they're going to send in the cavalry on this one. Oh, man, did he take a hit. Well, the offense heading back out onto the field after that kick, hoping to turn this drive into another touchdown.
This quarterback right now is in a rhythm. A lot of that has to do with his preparation. You can see right now with the reads that he's being able to make, getting the football out of his hands, that he's feeling very, very confident in his ability to throw the football against this defense.
From their own 49-yard line, second down. Gains his way to the 43-yard line. That makes it first and 10. Run there. Norman picks up five with the carry. That brings him second and five. And so that's going to do it. Our final score in this one, 31-10, Hawkeye. Kirk, go ahead and just give us your reflections on this game.
You know, I think it was a well-played game for the most part. Indiana probably feels they should have won this game, but they just didn't make enough big plays when they needed to.
puts them in the prestigious 10-win category for the season. And for Indiana, this loss will put a damper on what's been a great year.